Hello everyone, I Harmeet welcome you all on WsCube Tech. So in this video we are going to talk that how you can sell your products over Pinterest or through Pinterest. So if you have a business where you sell any kind of goods or services, then Pinterest could be the platform that could boost your sales and grow. You can grow your business, right? So let's get started. So first we will talk about that why you should use Pinterest to boost your sale, or so you should sell your business or your products over Pinterest, right? So my answer would be that it is a growing market, right? A vast network of audience, your customers are there globally as well as in India. It is a growing market, so you'll get a large amount of customers on Pinterest, right? And another important feature that Pinterest has, that you can attach any product URL to any pin or post you put over Pinterest, right? So you, any post can be attached to a particular product, so anybody will come to your post and it will click on that page or on that picture, it will be directed to that product, right? So from that you will get the organic reach to your profile, right? So this is an amazing platform and it is growing, a large amount of audiences there, and the targeting audience is really easy here. And if you know your niche, if you know your topic, if you know what are you doing and what type of products are you are selling, then it is really easy to target the audience and sell your product there, right? So let's get started. Today I'm going to tell you about that how you can sell your products online over Pinterest, right? By using Pinterest or either through Pinterest. So first thing that you have to do is to create a brand, right? What is a branding? How you can brand your products? That to create a perception about your products or your company. For that, at least start with creating a logo. A logo will symbolize your products, and you can sell your products that can create an image in front of the audience, right? In the eyes of audience, you'll get an image. So that you have to do. So first of all, you have to brand your product, at least create a logo or specify some things that you are selling and what are your specialties, right? So start with branding, and then the first thing you'll do is to create a business account, right? You have to create a business account in order to use Pinterest to sell your business, right? If you want to use this Pinterest for the professional use, then you should have a professional account, a business account. So create a business account. I already have created a video on that how you can create an account on Pinterest, and I have also showed you that how you can convert your personal account to the business account, right? So just create a business account, create a logo, and then just know your audience, what type of audience you want your product to buy and what type of audience is there on the Pinterest, right? So just know your audience, what do they want, what kind of content they want to see, and how you will direct your audience to your website. So just know your audience and know the trends. There's another thing that you have to follow the trend, right? Just follow the trend, that what is trending on the Pinterest, what your audience wants to see. And for these two options, how to know your audience and how to follow the trend, there's a small thing, small tip I want to give you, that for that we need to go to the Pinterest. Okay, so here we are in this analytics section. You have to go to the audience insights, and in audience insights you can see your complete audience, and from this section, all Pinterest users, you can see that what total audience of Pinterest wants to see and what are their interested categories. As you can see, the home decor is a category. The most of the audience is interested in this category, and these are like subcategories according to the percentage of the people who are interested in these, right? So from there you can see that what is trending. As you can see that home decor is trending, really trending, food and drinks, art, beauty, right? So this is a sequence of the categories or the product that are really popular over Pinterest. So from there you can get to know that what is trending, and you can create your content according to that, right? And you can just relate it to your products you are selling, right? For example, if you have a furniture business, so you can just create the content relating to home decor, and then you can relate it to your business. I have already made a video on that is on how to grow your business if you are an e-commerce website user or you are a furniture business owner. So you can check the link in the description. You'll see that video there. Okay, so from here you can see what is trending and how much percent it has been trained and how much a percent of audience wants to see content like this, right? So you can get the trending ideas from here and you can prepare your content or create your content according to that, right? And if you just scroll down, you will see this, that here is your audience. You can see the age distribution of the audience and the gender distribution from on and the devices used by all the audience globally, right? So from there, you can get an idea that what kind of audience do you have on Pinterest so that you need to prepare the content according to them only, right? So from this section in the analytics, in the audience insights, you'll get an idea that what is trending and what your audience wants to see and how is your audience. So you can prepare your content according to that and you can relate your that content with your products you are selling, right? So this is a pro tip. So our last tip would be that. Okay, so let's move on to the next tip. Next tip would be to do the keyword analysis, right? Whenever we are talking about a social media or a search engine, and Pinterest is a combination of both social media and as well as the search engine. So you have to do the social media optimization or search engine optimization. And in order to do that, you have to do the keyword analysis. Just find out few keywords of your niche, right? So if you are a blogger, then find some keywords relating to your blogs, what kind of blogs you are making. You can create that list of the keyword that you are going to use either in your profile or your post, right? So just do a keyword analysis according to your business and as well as the trend, right? I have already made a video over keyword analysis, that how you can find out some keywords, some good keywords that are related to your business and as well as the trend, right? So keyword analysis is another key, and the good keywords will get you a boost in your business as well as in your Pinterest profile, right? So do your keyword analysis wisely. So our next tip would be that optimize your profile according to the keyword you chose, right? So I have already told you that optimizing your profile is really important. We have talked about it in the SEO video and the keyword analysis video also, right? Because you do the keyword research and then you place those keywords into different places, right? And two of the places comes in the profile, and one is your profile name or your profile description, right? Both of them should contain some good keywords that depicts your business as well as the trend, right? So you must put some trending keywords into your profile as well as in your profile description. I'll show you an example. So this is our profile, and we provide the services related to the digital marketing and web development or app development. So I have put some keywords in my profile name. This is my profile name, WsCube Tech. This is our company's name. And digital marketing is the type of content we provide, right? And the web and app development. So you can see I have added two or three keywords in my profile name. And as you can see our description is WsCube Tech offers services like web development, web designing, Android and iPhone app development and digital marketing services. So from that you can see that I have also added few keywords in our description also. So you have to optimize your profile. So this would be our first step in optimizing profile, that put your profile name and use some keywords here, and as well as in your description. So this would be our first tip in optimizing your profile. Second would be put a good resolution logo. You have to create a logo. If you do not have a website, right, it's okay, but at least create a logo and put a good cover page here, so it can just reflect what type of content you are going to provide. So I have already talked about in our settings, Pinterest setting video. So go and check that out so that you will get to know that what kind of important settings that you have to do, right? So let's move on. Okay, the another important tip for you to before starting selling your business is to claim your website. Claiming your website is really important if you want to use Pinterest for the professional use or if you want to sell your products by using Pinterest. So just claim your website. If you do not have a website, then it's okay. You can just use your other social media's profile URL or your Facebook URL or any YouTube channel's link that you want your audience to go there and check your content out, right? So just claim your website or put any website URL over your Pinterest account, right? So I have already made a video on claim your website. You can just check that out if you are having a problem. Okay, so just claiming your website is really important. Now our next tip would be that to put efforts on content creation, because as I've already told you that Pinterest is all about beautiful things, beautiful content, aesthetic things, right? So just put your efforts on the content creation, write some good blogs, make some good pictures. I have also introduced you to the Canva website in the content creation video, so go check that video out. In that video, I have talked about content creation, that how you can create beautiful content with a very short of time, right? So just put your efforts on the content creation. Just as I've also already told you that to know your audience and following the trend is really important. So just know your audience, follow the trend and create the beautiful content according to that. Right? Because people come to Pinterest when they want impressive and beautiful content or the inspirations, right? So create an inspiration for others, create some beautiful graphics, create some beautiful pictures and post them so that people will click them and they will go to your website or your e-commerce website, because Pinterest is after all about beauty. Okay. So our next tip would be that to pin, RePin and Rich Pen. Okay, let's talk about each, right? First, you have to pin, like post in like 3 times or 5 times at least a day, right? You have to post some pictures, either post some idea pins or post some videos, right? No matter what kind of post you are making, just pin some good images, beautiful images, good videos or the idea stories you put. You have to maintain the consistency and keep pinning, right? So that people will come to you and see that every day that person is posting. So you'll get more impressions or engagements, right? So the another thing is RePin, right? Along with pinning your own content, along with creating your own content, you have to follow other people's of your niche. Like for example, if you are a photographer, then find out some good photography page on Pinterest and follow their content and save their pins into your profile, right? We have already talked about it, that how you can repin other people's pictures or their posts, right? So to go to their content, if you like something, just post that onto your profile. What you will get from this, you will get some good aesthetics over your profile. Some beautiful content will be your profile and it will be seen from your profile. So it will help you to generate your profile in a short span of time. And till then, you can just pin and create your own content, right? So pin and repin are really important. Now let's talk about Rich Pen. Okay, so what is a rich pin? Rich pin is a type of pin which is just like basic pin, but it contains more information than a regular pin. Okay, so how you can enable rich pin, that I have talked in a different video, that you have to just enable your website. If you have a website, only then you'll be able to enable the rich pin. Rich pin, you'll have an extra information. For example, there's a product which is in your website. So if you post the same product over Pinterest as a pin, that information over that website for that particular pin will automatically will get synced to that pin you are posting on the Pinterest, right? So it will just show like some extra information. If you are, for example, you are posting a recipe, so all the ingredient list and all the recipe direction will get transferred to that pin over the Pinterest, right? So this is what we call rich pin, and rich pin in 2021 has been a major reason to drive boost or audience to your profile, right? So just pin, repin and rich pin, right? So next advice for you is to link your products to your website. I have already talked about a lot that the most important feature that Pinterest has, that you can link any product with your website and anybody would click that product or that picture, it will be directed to that particular URL you wanted them to send. Right? So just link your product to your website. Let me show you how you can do that. Okay, so you have to go to the create and you can just click create. You can select a simple picture, right? I'm gonna select this particular picture. Okay, make sure it's in 2:3 ratio, right? And just put your title here and your description and the alt text. I have talked about it in the earlier video called how to pin, right? So you can check that out. And add a destination link. You can just click to any URL you want to send your audience to, right? For example, I'm checking my own website, okay? Okay, so this is our website and I want this URL to be linked to this particular post. So, I'm just gonna copy this website's URL and I'm gonna paste it here. Okay, so I'm gonna paste it here and you can just publish it, and as soon as you publish it, this link will be connected to this particular post and anybody would come to Pinterest or see this pin and it can just click it and that person will be directed to your website, and from that option you will get the organic reach, right? So this is really important. If you attach every post with a particular link of your website or a particular web page, it's okay if you don't have a website or a particular e-commerce website. If you are selling something over the Pinterest or Flipkart, or even if you are selling on Facebook or Instagram, so you can connect any URL. If you are selling on Amazon, you can just copy the URL of that particular product you want to sell and you can attach it to that particular post over the Pinterest. And if you have Instagram, if you are selling on Instagram, then you can attach the link of your URL or that particular post to the post over the Pinterest, just like I have showed you here, right? So just link your products to your website and that's how you'll get high customer and a large audience. So our next tip for you, if you want to sell by using Pinterest or on Pinterest, then give value to your audience. If a person comes to your profile, even if he don't wants to buy anything, just give him some value. At least he don't buy anything, but he gets some ideas from your content or your profile. So just give value to that person and that person will come back, or in some time he'll definitely buy something, or at least you'll get some impression, your profile will get popular and it will reach to more people so that any interested buyer can come to you, right? And the most important thing is that on Pinterest, the browser to buyer ratio is really high. If a person come across your profile, then there are chances that he's willing to buy something, right? He's willing to buy your content. And make sure if 100 people comes to your website or your Pinterest profile, if even one of them wants to buy something or actually buy something, you'll get a good amount of sale like within a short span of time. So just make your account, don't wait over, make a business account, create your account, watch this series, whole series over there. You can get link of the playlist in the description, right? So just start learning Pinterest, start creating content for the Pinterest and start selling. If this video was useful for you, then hit the like button. If there's any suggestion or questions, you can comment down, and thank you so much.